Hi everyone, it's DJ Henry. I'm getting ready to go to work, but I just wanted to make a quick video. I really had to make this video. Last night, I finally had a chance to get back on YouTube and start going through some of the comments on the video I did on how our family almost died due to gun violence. And if you want to watch that video, I will link it in the description box below. I just wanted to get on here and say thank you. I was so overwhelmed at all of the comments, and I'm so sorry it took me so long to respond. As you can imagine, a lot's been going on. I really miss YouTube. I really miss the community. I really miss creating and uploading. So I'm really looking forward to getting back into that. I can't believe that it's been June, July, August, like 3 months since the incident happened. It feels like it was yesterday and it feels like it was so long ago. Some mornings I wake up and I think about it. It's just the first thing on my mind, and sometimes it's the last thing on my mind before bed. I was in a really kind of down place last night, and for some reason I was like, let me find the comment section and, you know, just kind of, you know, see if there's any comments I need to respond to. I was just overwhelmed at all of the wonderful comments that you guys left me. It really means a lot. It just proves how awesome you guys are and how meaningful the YouTube community can be. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your hugs. Thank you for your virtual hugs. Thank you for your words of encouragement. Everything is appreciated. I just went to bed with a smile on my face, just kind of not feeling alone. And I wanted to share what happened on YouTube, not for attention or anything like that. It took me a few days to decide, but I really wanted to share what God had done for our family. I did see a comment where, you know, they said, see, God didn't protect your family. What about the people that die, you know, the innocent people that die? And all I could say was, yeah, I keep asking questions too. Like, I have asked those questions. What about the people that die and things like that? When it comes down to it, all I can say is, in the midst of trial and in the midst of danger, whatever the outcome is, God is there. It's really easy on the outside looking in to 9/11 or what's happening with Ferguson or just other terrorizing, traumatic things that we see from the outside. It's easy to say, where is God? God wasn't there. But I know that some of you that have been through things and do rely on your faith, you can see God show up, and those trials are supposed to build character. Like, the Bible does talk about why we go through trials, and yeah, in the midst of it, you can ask those questions like, why? I've done that before. But this time, all I could do was say, Jesus, like, seriously, here is the pillow. This is the pillow, and that is the bullet hole. This is the pillow that my daughter was sleeping on, and she still sleeps on it every night. This is a reminder of God's goodness. It's not like, oh my gosh, you know, I'm angry at God. How can I be angry at him? Okay, I'm human. I get angry. I get frustrated. I have my moments. So I can't let my human emotions take over. They're there. I acknowledge them. I listen to them, but we have a choice, and I have a choice, and I have to remind myself, I can stay here and go down that road because I know where it leads and it's a dark place, or I can make myself get out of it and remind myself to be grateful. I don't even think that's just something that Christians think about. I think that everyone thinks about the importance of gratitude in their life and the fact it's always worse for somebody else. And we all have those thoughts, and we all get frustrated, and we all get angry. The filter that I have, I can't just see the world through my eyes as a human. I have to choose to look at things in the bigger picture. Because in that small picture, it's like, why, God? Why this bad? And why this happened? And why this happened to my family? And blah, blah, blah. But then the bigger picture is, what is this changing in my children? What can I teach my children during this time? How can my marriage get stronger? What can we look to for the future? What issues did this bring up? It showed us where we were slacking as a family. It showed me where I was slacking as a mom. I'm not gonna lie, it's not easy. It's not easy recovering. It's not easy when months have gone by and you feel like you should be over it and the rest of the world is going by and I'm still tearing up during the day. I'm still worried. I'm still dealing with all of these emotions. So I'm getting off track right now, but because this morning was an emotional morning, I really had to spend some time praying. I came on here to say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for speaking up and responding and commenting. Thank you for taking the time to watch. Thank you for affirming that I have sisters in Christ out there praying for me, and new ones to meet. And it's always wonderful as you expand your family, you know, like there's other brothers and sisters in Christ out there and you're not alone. I wanted to kind of go back to something I said in that video a few months ago about changing what I do on YouTube. And I've been thinking about the fearless journey. I really can't believe I said that. I said I wanted to be more fearless, and I have been brought through things to make me less fearless. But still, even though I've been through all that, I am struggling with knowing in my heart what I want to do next and doing it. Inspire Cafe still seems like my playground, and I think I really just need a place to play, to be myself fully, like all of me. And we all need those places. And a lot of times in our lives, I feel like, oh, I have to be more professional here. I can't be so quirky here. That person's gonna think I'm weird and emotional over there. But over here, when I'm acting, it's really good to be weird and emotional. For me, I really love to explore and learn and get feedback and community. And that's how I learn and grow as a person. So I think I'm just gonna keep going in that direction. And that's something I'm working on, is not overthinking. Kind of go forward with my instincts and what I'm enjoying, because it's okay to enjoy what you're doing without always thinking about what it can become and what's the bigger picture, blah, blah, blah. One thing I mentioned in my YouTube tag was I wanted to do some mommy skits, because that's what I started off doing. So I'm definitely gonna add some mommy comedy in there. I think this is a great time. I'm seeing a lot of that stuff kind of pop up. And I think when I started, there wasn't really any moms doing anything like that, and it was like cricket, cricket, cricket when I put out a video. I kind of went into a community where there was more videos and more people and DIYs, which I love, and it's a huge part of me, and I'm gonna keep doing DIY videos. Some more film book reviews, thoughts about things that are happening in the world. And that's kind of, it's really hard for me. I'm really opinionated, but I'm not one to share my opinion unless I've really cultivated how I'm gonna say it and how I'm gonna be like non-offensive and things like that. But that's something I really wanna get over. This vlog is getting pretty long and I do have to go to work. Work meaning starting my own business, doing freelance video production and blogging for people. I'm trying to get this going. Gotta hustle. Yeah, maybe I'll talk more about that too if you guys are interested in entrepreneurial journeys and things like that. My husband's an entrepreneur. He's had his own business for like 5 or 6 years, and that's how we've been living. God has been providing. He has a web development company where he does web applications, like iPhone apps, like just cool stuff, like whatever. If you have an idea for an app or a web application, like he makes it happen for people. I want an app one day, I really do. Yeah, this video has a lot of stuff in it. I have some stuff coming up for Sweatpants and High Heels. I will link that channel down below. We are getting ready to shoot some more episodes and hopefully finish up the season this year. So I can.
Man voice.
Man voice.
Hopefully finish up the season so that I can share more videos with you guys. We're gonna start a fundraising campaign so we can finish up. I am gonna continue on this fearless journey. I'm gonna continue to push myself to get over myself. Most of all, thank you. It's a hug from me to you. Thank you for not being quiet. Thank you for watching. Thank you for commenting, saying something, for praying. If you have prayer requests, I really don't mind if you leave them below. I mean, if you feel okay with it, if you have an unspoken prayer request, like, if I read through it and I see someone, like, I need prayer for this, I will pray. I will just stop and pray. And I just think prayer is awesome. I really do. So I'm gonna get my butt to work and start posting. Really excited to get back to YouTubing. I have some more DIY videos that I'm gonna release. I have an interview with a mom coming out, and then I have some comedy I'm gonna try out on you guys. So thanks for tuning in. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for subscribing. Awesome. Have a great day. I love you guys.